Hello friends, my name is Gautam Mehra and I'm here to talk today a little bit about what is probably one of the most important tax developments across the world, which is BEPS, or Base Erosion and Profit Shifting. I will just speak a little bit about the background of how this has come about, maybe touch upon four or five important areas that are important for taxpayers, especially in India, and then end up with some concluding remarks. In the recent times, there's been increased media attention and attention from the public and non-government organizations around international tax avoidance. So in this backdrop, the G20 member countries got together and have requested the OECD to come up with some form of international tax framework which seeks to address these flaws. The OECD, over the last couple of years, has acted pretty swiftly and has come to a stage where they have identified 15 action plans. That's due to happen early October 2015, when the member countries are also expected to get together and sign off on some of this. It'll be useful to see what are the key themes around these action plans which the OECD has proposed, and how is it likely to impact taxpayers. Let me speak about a few of them. To start off with, this whole concept of permanent establishments, and the proposal is to try and ensure that permanent establishment is not sought to be artificially avoided by fragmenting business units into small areas of operations. Now, this is easier said than done, and that takes me on, you know, to the next topic about e-commerce. The business models in e-commerce have evolved dramatically, and tax laws have just not been able to keep pace with them. So the OECD is also looking at and trying to figure out where is it that the value gets generated, and where is it that those profits out of those activities need to be taxed. Another important area in the Indian context as well is about treaty abuse. The use of tax treaties to achieve what is called a double non-taxation objective is sought to be eliminated. And the other aspect about this also is trying to ensure that entities are not incentivized to locate what are called CFCs, or other holding or operating companies, in jurisdictions which have a low cost base. A fourth area, again, which is very critical and important in the Indian context, is around transfer pricing. And the focus here is to try and ensure that a mere contractual obligation on account of risk or capital does not seek to move profits away from one location to the other. In fact, the focus is more on, does the entity in that jurisdiction have people with adequate experience and quality to be able to drive those risks and allocate the capital? The other area around transfer pricing is also around the need for increased transparency and the whole concept of going through the country by country reporting, where tax authorities in every jurisdiction are able to get a larger picture of the activities of an MNC and get to analyze as to what is the value that the business model of the MNC derives in each jurisdiction. Fear on the lack of confidentiality. A fifth area, which is also of importance in this context, is about dispute resolution. Now, one can well imagine that with all these changes happening and several countries seeking to protect their tax base, and of course the increased transparency that I spoke about, there are bound to be disagreements or disputes between member states on how these profits are to be allocated. And therefore the group does also look at suggesting ways on how to ensure that whenever a dispute is not capable of getting resolved under what is called the mutual agreement procedure, what alternative dispute resolution mechanisms can be adhered to. Now, that's easier said than done, because as we speak, the group has not been able to come across and get a buy-in, but we'll see where that goes. So friends, these were a few of the important areas which would need to be looked at. And if I may just, you know, mention in conclusion, this obviously is very important for governments, because not only do they want to seek to protect the tax base in their respective jurisdictions, but there's a need to finally balance the need for increased transparency and protecting the tax base with the need to ensure confidentiality of information and the need to ensure that this does not put an unnecessarily high compliance burden on businesses operating in their jurisdictions. With the government's mantra of wanting to make India as a place of where it is easy to do business and come up in the ranks amongst global jurisdictions, I think this is a very interesting platform for taxpayers to come together with policymakers to provide some constructive and positive inputs and suggestions, such that the government protects its tax base, but at the same time, we move ahead on the objective of making it making life more simpler for MNCs to do business in India. We'll be connected, and that's all for now. Thank you.